Hey guys, welcome back. Thanks for joining us today on The King of Random. There are a lot of ways to cook things, and today we're going to try one of the least conventional ones. We're going to run a high electric current directly through our food to see how it reacts. The general setup is pretty simple. We'll have electricity attached to two different nails and our food spiked onto the top of it, connecting the bridge. When we turn on the electricity, we'll see what happens to the food. I do want to be doing this with food that is somewhat conductive, or nothing's gonna happen when we plug in the electricity. So the two foods I'm gonna try this with are hot dogs and pickles. Both have high water and sodium content, so they should conduct electricity fairly well. All right, here we go. I'll drive the nails through this board to hold them steady as we run the electricity through them. First, let's cut off a small piece that's easier to manage. With our board cut, we want to drive the two nails through, pointing straight up, far enough apart that they have some space between them, but not so far that we can't fit a hot dog on them. I could just drive the nail in using a hammer, but it doesn't actually need to be in all that tight since it's not holding any two pieces of wood together. So I'm just gonna pre-drill it with a drill bit that's slightly smaller than the width of the nail. With the holes drilled, now let's press the nail all the way through the board so that the head of the nail is flush with the bottom. With the nails driven through the board, we need to add a source of electricity. I have here a cord that I cut off of an old broken fan. I'm going to split the wire in half and then strip off about the top 2 inches of each side of the wire. Now let's take these wires and wrap each one around the base of one of the nails. And there we have it. Now our electric cooking device is ready to be used. All we have to do is impale our food onto it and then plug it in. It's important to note that these are live exposed wires and they pose a risk of electric shock. So this is not an experiment that should be replicated at home. We have a workbench that's designed for these types of experiments and we have safety precautions in place. Let's start trying to cook a hot dog. Now the outlet I'm using actually does have a switch installed, so no electricity is gonna start flowing into the outlet until I turn it on. This is a good safety measure. In case something goes wrong, you can just hit the switch without having to pull the plug out from the wall. All right, safety glasses on, and I'm gonna flip the switch. I can smell it. I don't know if I could smell it before and I'm just close to it, or if it started cooking and doing something. Ooh, I can hear it. It's making fizzling noises. And it's sort of bubbling up down here at the bottom. I think it might be boiling some of the water inside the hot dog, possibly burning it as well. It does smell like burning. But I'm gonna turn it off and see what's happened so far. Well, I've got a nice charred spot on one side of my hot dog. The other side doesn't seem very effective, and I thought more of it would get warm. I've been told that doing this setup, you can actually cook the hot dog all the way through and that it will often get so hot that it will split open from the heat, kind of like if you microwave it. But I'm not really getting any of that result. It's not cooking all the way through. It's not really getting hot. It's just sort of heating up the one spot that's actually in contact with the nail, and a little bit of heat is radiating out from that, but it doesn't seem to be running much current through the hot dog. Well, cooking a hot dog didn't work all that well, but I do have another experiment I want to try, and that is to see what happens if we impale a pickle on our nails and run electricity through it. I've heard there can be some interesting results, so let's test it out. Right, we need a pickle that is long enough to reach between the spikes pretty well. That'll work. All right, electricity's off. Stab my pickle onto the nails. All right. Our pickle is spiked, we've got wires running to it. Let's turn on the electricity and see what happens to our pickle. Well, it's dripping pickle juices down again. Oh! That is the electric arc burning its way through the pickle. Look how much that's lighting up all around that nail. All right, you know what? I'm gonna turn the electricity off for a second. I want to try turning off the lights and seeing what that looks like with a little more darkness around here. Now we've got a new pickle. We've dimmed the lights quite a bit. So we're going to put this one on, turn on the electricity, and see how much that sparking shows up. Ooh. Going on both sides. That's exciting. Got a glowing pickle. It's glowing! That is one electric pickle. I'm gonna try impaling it on one side first, then touch the other side. Let's See if I can switch which side. Yeah, now that's the side that's sparking. Just to see if it makes any difference, I'm gonna try drilling a new hole and moving one of the nails closer so that we only have about an inch and a half in between the two to see what happens. There's a shorter pickle for this. All right, electricity on. 3, 2, 1. We got glowing again. A little bit of ozone smell too, that's interesting. The nail has hollowed out, just burned its way through a trough in the pickle. That's exciting. Well, there you have it, cooking directly with electricity. I'm gonna say that this does not actually work very well. We got some good glow out of the pickles and I was pretty amused how much it would carve a path through the pickle wherever it was in contact with the nail. I've got some ideas of how we could amp this project up to the next level, including hooking it up to a microwave transformer. That same setup has made metal glowing red hot or even liquefying very quickly. So I'm curious what would happen if you ran that much power through a hot dog or a pickle. It might just explode, which would be pretty great. This has been a fun project. Thanks for joining us today and we'll see you in the next one. Talk to you then. But overall, I would say that on the scale of how to cook hot dogs, this is probably near the bottom. I would say it goes cooking on a campfire, then on a barbecue, then on a skillet on the stove, and then boiling it, and then somewhere down near the floor would be impaling your hot dog on nails and plugging those nails into the wall. It's just a terrible way to cook a hot dog.
Hey guys, if you are on Twitter, come follow me on Twitter at the King of Random. It's a great place to connect with me one-on-one. That's all I'm gonna say about that, because if you want to, you will, and if you don't, you won't. So I will see you there, or maybe I won't.